Organic, true, urban breakbeat culture.
This is dBridge representing Exit Records, here to talk about Mosaic and other things. I'm just at that stage where it's like, you know, I'm quite lucky to sort of still be here in some sense. You know, drum and bass has been really good to me. You know, I could say that this is my sort of third incarnation in some ways. I've had, you know, Future Forces, Bad Company, and it's now me doing what I'm doing on my own. So it's like I've just need to keep pushing myself, and you know, drum and bass is sometimes it boils my piss, do you know what I mean? As a genre and as a scene, and traditionally what I've done when he has done that is buggered off and gone to make music with my brother, but he's living in Australia now, so I haven't got that. So what I did was I started working with instrumental instead, and it was good because, you know, those guys, they've just been out of the scene for, they were out of the scene for so long, and literally just decided, you know, we're going to come back and make some music, and sort of stepped back in as if they'd never left. So it was like, you know, I got caught up in the whole software all in the box and the convenience of it, and it is, you know, it's great, it's good. But there was, you know, listening to them and listening to, you know, there was something missing for me, and it was that almost sort of time consuming kind of trying to get a bloody decent sound out of something that they just was just effortless for them, and they just gave me this sort of rekindled my love of the equipment that I had, and this sort of realization that it suddenly dawned on me. It's like, oh, I've got all this stuff, and they'd be talking about this equipment, and I was like, yeah, I've got one of those. And I'm like, what? And, you know, yeah, I've got one of those. It's like, it amazed them that I wasn't using it, and it kind of amazed me thinking now I look back at it.
So, you know, we'd be there working in the studio, and it was just, you know, they'd have this synth there, that synth there, and another one on the other side, and I missed that kind of interaction of people making music, you know, and it'd be a cacophony of absolute nonsense coming out of the keyboards, but eventually there'd be this kind of moment where, actually, that sounds all right. You know, yeah, right, okay, put that down. And then we used to call it the fingerless fog, the frequency fog. It was just like, some of the, you know, things coming out, I was like, geez, come on, hold it down. But it was just that every now and then there'd be this, you know, because we're not accomplished musicians as such, so there'd be this moment of like this sort of 16 bars where we were actually really tight together, you know, as a band, like jamming. And I just really liked that. And it just kind of reminded me of, like, you know, when I was working with Future Forces with Maldini, and the things that we used to do, just kind of the keyboards, he'd be on the desk, live EQ sweeps, reverb splashes. And the same working with Nico, that was a kind of real pivotal moment in my career as well. When we did tracks together and he'd come in and engineer for us, and it was just kind of like, wow. Okay, just being able to transform one sound into so many different things. And it's that kind of tactile, hands-on nature that you don't get with soft synths. You can't really, you know, that doesn't do it for me anymore. I didn't have that many synths. I had quite a little bit of outboard sort of effects and stuff like that. And then I've just sort of acquired synths in the last sort of 2-3 years. I bought that JXAP, Roland JXAP of mine, which he now regrets selling to me. But yeah, I got that. I just suddenly got the bug, so I've just been sort of buying some synths ever since. And just, you know, it gives you that, each, especially with the old stuff, it's just each one have got their own personalities in some ways. It's like, I know I made a sound on there yesterday, I know if I play it now, it won't sound anything like how it did yesterday. And it's just that temperamental nature of them that I like, and it's kind of like that one moment, that, you know, that instant of, okay, that, you know, and now go into the track, and then, but with a soft synth, you know, you're going to turn it on, get the preset up, and it's just always going to sound the same, and it's, But for me as well, it was that thing of like knowing that everyone else would have access to the same bank of sounds I didn't like. So especially nowadays with the, you know, things like it's quite easy to reverse engineer other people's music. Oh, they did that with that, they did that with that. So the thing is kind of this, it seems like a next, it's going back, you know, that thing of going back to go forward, really, just kind of going back to this old equipment, and just how I used to look at music. Yeah, so it's the second album. I've started it and finished it numerous times, and it just, it's only till now, because I've recently just moved into this space, and a lot of the stuff has been here, there and everywhere. A lot of the equipment has been, you know, lent to people, or it's never been in all in one space, or, you know, I've had a setup in my front room and it's kind of like, well, if I want to invite people down, it's not really, it didn't really feel right to kind of like invite singers down to come and sit in my front room and sing on an album. So it's like, I've been waiting for a space like this, and this has sort of finally come along. And it just feels right now, because like I said, I felt like I was selling myself short with what I was doing before. I was making tracks which I liked, but they weren't what I ultimately wanted them to be, because I didn't have everything around me. So now I'm gonna start again, and see what happens. I've kind of, you know, there's this whole, because I've started singing now, which is a new thing for me. I've been doing it for a while, but it's a new thing for me to be quite open with it and risk putting it on the record. I think, you know, that's going to be something that I'm going to explore, want to explore.
It's that thing of me pushing myself. So, I mean, let's see, I've had the thing like with Inner Disbelief, Glimpse, the thing on Martin's album, Seems Like, sort of co-wrote, and then I wrote the lyrics on Justified on Breakage's album. So I'm really getting into that kind of whole songwriting, and enjoying that side of things, because it is, see, it's adding another string to my bow. So I think this album is probably going to be a lot of me warbling and giving it a go, and we'll see what happens. I'm nervous as hell, not sure how people are going to take it, whether it's going to be, you know, with a lot of drum and bass on there, I don't know. But I think, you know, I've been doing this long enough to be able to do what the hell I want now. So we'll see what happens. But I think, you know, see, this album's just, the Mosaic album's just come out. I've got these other albums coming out. So it kind of gives me time to spend time and really concentrate on what I'm doing. So it takes the heat off me a little bit, because the label's still, you know, got content coming out. So I'm hoping by the end of the year, I'll have something to put out. Yeah, we'll see. True urban breakbeat culture, organic.
Organic. True urban breakbeat culture.